If you're not taking vitamin C every single day, you should watch this video. This is gonna be the first video out of four, so stay tuned. Hey, if we're just meeting now, I'm Orit and welcome to my channel. In this video, I'm gonna cover three basic things you have to know about vitamin C. Let's begin. Vitamin C, or ascorbic acid, or L-ascorbate, is the safest, most amazing vitamin you should be getting every single day. Vitamin C is considered an essential micronutrient. An essential means your body can't make it, you have to get it from foods or supplements. The reason you have to take it every single day is because it's water-soluble. Water-soluble means your body doesn't store it like other fat-soluble vitamins. It uses it right away, and any extra is leaving your body within 3 to 4 hours. And that's why you want to make sure you're taking it every single day. However, some areas have vitamin C stored in very, very small amounts. These areas are like the brain, your eyes, your testes, your ovaries, even in your glands, your pituitary gland and your adrenal glands. You need 200 milligrams to maintain these stores. However, if you're drinking alcohol or you're smoking cigarettes or you have any underlying diseases or you're just stressed out, you need more vitamin C. The RDA is between 50 and 90 milligrams a day. But if you know that the stores that needs to be maintained, you need minimum of 200 grams, it just makes you think if the RDA is really on point, or maybe it was determined so long ago that it needs to be updated. Vitamin C is easily oxidized in air, and it's very sensitive to heat and light. It's one of the most unstable vitamins. Number two, vitamin C is a powerful antioxidant. In order to understand what is antioxidant, let's talk about oxidation. Oxidation is a normal process that happens through metabolism, for example, when your body converts food into energy. It creates free radicals or oxidized molecules. Oxidized molecules or free radicals, when there's too much of them, it's creating oxidized stress. That stress is the key driver to inflammation, chronic disease. So we want to make sure we don't have so many free radicals, although not all free radicals are actually harmful. But when you have a lot of them, it's creating that stress, oxidized stress. Free radicals causes rapid aging. Without getting too deep into it, a free radical is a molecule that is missing an electron. Vitamin C is an antioxidant, deoxidizes the molecule by donating an electron. Amazing. I love this stuff. I can geek out on it all day. After vitamin C donated an electron to the free radical, and now it's already neutralized, vitamin C is missing an electron, but it's getting a donation from other antioxidants. So it's kind of like this beautiful cycle. If you don't have enough vitamin C, you are missing out on this magic. If you're getting value out of this, smash the like button and subscribe to my channel. Moving forward to number three, vitamin C is a cofactor. It's just a molecule that helps enzymes and chemical reactions. So vitamin C is assisting all of the metabolic reactions, fatty acid metabolism, immune function. We all know vitamin C in relation to the flu and when you get a cold. So that's exactly what vitamin D is doing. Maybe it's not curing, but it's definitely helping these enzymes in your immune system to work better. And now moving to fun fact about vitamin C is the difference between us and animals. Animals are making their own vitamin C in the liver from glucose that turning into vitamin C. They're making every single day about 10,000 milligrams of vitamin C. Like if you think about it, animals don't have chronic diseases. They do get infections, but once they have an infection, they just produce a lot more vitamin C. 100,000 milligrams of vitamin C, that's a lot. We don't have the ability to produce vitamin C, but we do have the responsibility to consume enough vitamin C. And not just when you have a cold or when you have the flu, but maintain it every single day. In the next video, I'm gonna dive into the benefits of taking vitamin C and what are the symptoms of deficiency. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in my next video.